Coming up, we take a look at how anyone can easily build automated, no-code chatbot experiences with Power Virtual Agents, which gives you a fast, intuitive, and AI-rich way to create intelligent bots that make decisions and take actions. So I'm joined today by Emma Archer from the Power Virtual Agents team. Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics.
Thank you for inviting me.
Thanks again for joining us today, Emma. Now, before we get started and go further, for those of you who are new to Power Virtual Agents, it's Microsoft's newest member of the Power Platform, our family of tools for low to zero code modern app development, process automation, business insights, and now chatbots. Now, Power Virtual Agents, this isn't your average chatbot creation service, but what's different about this approach?
A few things. Power Virtual Agents is a SaaS, which means there's no setup involved. You just sign up and start building your chatbot. And we're not talking about building a simple Q&A chatbot. It goes way beyond that. Quite literally, anyone can build a chatbot. Our graphical user interface makes it super easy to get started. You can seed your chatbot with FAQ content from existing websites, author topics with natural language using entities, variables, and slot filling to jump to pertinent questions. The chatbot can take actions based on specific conditions using Power Automate and connectors to connect to your backend systems. And you can extend your chatbot with Azure Bot Framework skills. You can also publish with a single click to different channels, and you can monitor the chatbot's performance and continuously make improvements over time.
And what I really like about this approach is that it really puts the power in the hands of subject matter experts. They don't have to be able to code or be a developer or have data science skills, but can we see one of these in action?
Absolutely. So let me start by showing you the end customer experience, and then I'll show you how to build one. I have here a chatbot on the Contoso flooring site, and it's designed to help customers get a cost estimate for a new floor. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm actually interested in hardwood flooring. And I am a returning customer, so let me pop in my email address so it can go ahead and look up my details. And you can see it welcomes me back and asks me to confirm that home address. It's correct. And now it's offering me the next available time slot. And that works for me, so I'll go ahead and take it, and everything's scheduled. I now have an appointment with Beth, and I'll get an email confirmation.
And this is a really natural set of interactions and kind of a natural experience and conversation. Now, the chatbot isn't just conversing, it's also taking actions too. So there's a lot here going on behind the scenes, but how did you build it?
The build experience is really the best part. It's super easy to get started. You just go to powervirtualagents.microsoft.com and click on the start free. And once you've signed up, you're going to land in the Power Virtual Agents designer and you're ready to create your first chatbot. You simply give it a name and click create. Now, I've already created a chatbot, so I can go ahead and get a head start on the design by ingesting content from an existing FAQ site. So I'll just copy the URL, come into topics, suggested, get started, paste that URL and click start. Now, it'll take a minute or two to ingest the content. So you can see here that the AI has successfully extracted the content and created suggestions to review. Now I can either choose to promote en masse, or more likely I'm going to review individually and determine which ones need a tweak before I accept them.
So how did you enable then the natural language conversation aspect of that?
By using natural language understanding, Power Virtual Agents is built on years of AI research and applied science. We have a universal language model that we've trained with a huge amount of data. It's been optimized for the way that people use language when interacting with chatbots. And that enables us to focus on what you mean rather than what you type. You can see here we have several trigger phrases for our flooring estimate topic. And it's a good idea to use between 5 and 10 to train the natural language model. I'll type in a phrase which is somewhat semantically similar. I want to get a kitchen flooring quote. And you can see that even though my wording doesn't match any of the trigger phrases, the chatbot understood and successfully launched the correct topic.
So it's pretty easy then to get started. When you showed us the chatbot, the experience on the website itself, the customer was actually specifying a specific floor type. But how was it able to recognize really what the customer was requesting in this case?
Well, our natural language understanding helps with that. We have what we call an entity, and that's basically a category of information such as a phone number, city, zip, or even a person's name. And Power Virtual Agents comes with a number of predefined entities, and you have the ability to define your own custom entities, which is what I've done here with flooring types. You can see that I've specified the various options that are available to get a quote about. And I've added a couple of synonyms for hardwood. So how is this used, this custom entity, within the topic itself? Within our flooring estimate, in the question node, you can select the custom flooring type entity from that drop-down list. And you can also have the option to define what buttons are available to the customer. For example, if I perhaps don't want to show carpet as an option, I can deselect it. You can also see here a couple of conditional branches for hardwood and laminate, but I have nothing for tile. So I'll go ahead and add a conditional node for that, and it will create a new branch for me to populate.
And all this kind of helps make that bot interaction more natural, right?
It does. And now I've added my entity to the topic dialog tree, there's more I can do with a capability called slot filling. This gives the chatbot even more flexibility in how it interacts with you. For example, if the first thing you asked for is a quote for hardwood flooring, it can skip over that question about what type of flooring and go directly onto the next one, making the interaction appear more human.
So this makes the process a lot more efficient, and the interaction itself is more intelligent. And it was really able to see and also take actions. And it was able to set up, in this case, an appointment with a flooring specialist. But how did that all work?
Great question. This is where Power Automate comes in. It makes it super easy to perform actions. You can see we're in the flooring topic right now. And because we have track between topics switched on, you'll be able to see our progress across the topics as we continue our conversation here in the test window. I click hardwood and it asks me if I'm a returning customer, and I say yes. And at this point, it's going to navigate us over to the other topic, schedule an appointment for returning customer. And this topic is calling two Power Automate flows. The first takes the email address that I provide and does a lookup to the Dynamics 365 instance to find the customer information and confirm it back to me. And the second is going to look up the next available time slot for an agent to do a home visit. And you can see here, this is the schedule appointment flow, and we can deep link into Power Automate to make edits as needed.
Okay, so now you've got everything built, but how do I go about then publishing the chatbot?
Once you've done with all the authoring and testing of your chatbot, you'll want to deploy it to the appropriate channels. And you can see here the available choices, the most common being custom website. And you can navigate to publish, click on the publish button to deploy the latest version of your content to any of the channels that you've already got configured.
Okay, so you've basically written once and published anywhere using supported connectors. But now you mentioned before, you can also look at the metrics that are kind of behind the chatbot experience.
That's right. So with Power Virtual Agents, you can monitor the performance of your chatbot and determine what changes you need to make to improve it. Probably one of the most important things. On our analytics summary page here, you can see the total sessions for a selected time period. A session basically starts when an end user starts chatting with the bot, and it ends when a problem is either resolved, escalated to a human agent, or abandoned. The engagement rate is a breadth measure, and it shows you what portion of the sessions the chatbot had content for, i.e. was able to trigger a topic for. To review the unengaged sessions, you can go to the Sessions tab and download the chat transcripts to review what topics potentially you need to add. The next three measures show you what portion of engaged sessions were resolved successfully versus escalated to a human agent versus abandoned. And obviously, the higher the resolution rate, the better performing your bot. You'll want to focus in on the topics that have a high escalation rate and a high abandoned rate, and review the chat transcripts to determine what improvements you can make to those specific topics.
And this is really good to see really how much easier it is now to build these types of intelligent chatbots from scratch. But what's next for you then and the team?
So we're adding a multi-user capability, so you can bring in numerous content experts to author the chatbot at the same time. And we're also adding the ability to create the chatbot in one of 20 plus languages, and a lot more in the coming months.
So thanks again so much for joining us today, Emma, and really that introduction to Power Virtual Agents. Now, if you're interested in testing this out for yourself, you can go to powervirtualagents.microsoft.com. Thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you next time. Goodbye for now.